Remote controls are the handheld devices we use every day for interacting with the electronic world. It was Nikola Tesla who gave us the idea of remote control systems. Let's try to understand the working principle of these devices.
Vatsal, can you make a guess which part of EM spectrum does this device exploit?
Is it ultraviolet?
No, any other guess?
Maybe it is infrared.
Yes, indeed. This amazing device has no wires, so it sends signals to the television using IR waves. If we look at the top of the remote control, we see an LED where IR radiations are emitted. When you press the remote control, a beam of IR wave travels from remote to TV.
IR radiation is simply the light we cannot see, which makes it great for communication. IR sources are all around us. Anshul, will you please explain how does the IR receiver in your TV picks out the signals from your remote among all the ambient IR present in the surroundings?
Yes, Vatsal. It's no good the remote control just sending out a burst of random infrared. Clearly, if your remote control has 20 or more buttons on it, it must have a way of sending out at least this many signals, each one different enough for your TV to be able to decode and understand it. When you press one of the buttons, the remote generates a systematic series of on-off infrared pulses that signal a binary code. The remote signal has four parts: header data to indicate the beginning of the signal. This is same for all the remote signals for a particular device. Then is the command, the order you are giving to your electronic device. It depends on which button you press. Successively, it has the address of the device to which you are commanding.
Oh, now I understood why it is not possible to control your neighbor's television with your remote, since its address might be different. I used to try it when I was a child.
Then is the stop signal to let the device know that signal is finished. Finally, the entire signal is amplified and sent to TV. Isn't it amazing that all this is completed within fractions of second?
Yes, it is amazing. But Anshul, too much infrared noise is present in our surroundings. What about it?
To distinguish between the ambient IR and required IR, the remote modulates the binary code to a frequency of around 38 to 40 kHz, since very few natural sources have this frequency.
But what is the meaning of frequency for a binary code? It's simply 0 and 1.
Yes, it means that when your remote sends 1, it isn't exactly a constant signal. It varies with the specified frequency so that the TV recognizes binary bit 1, which is being emitted from its own remote.
So how does the TV receive the signals?
See, IR remotes are based on the line of sight mode. They have to be directed in the line of sight of the TV receiver so that the receiver can catch the signals. Also, it is a very short range signal and gets attenuated very fast. You might have noticed that seldom TVs can't be operated from outside a certain range.
Achha, while watching TV, lying on a sofa, it's very annoying to get up and change the channel just because of the line of sight doesn't match with the television receiver. From the past few decades, science has gifted us various ways to make our life comfortable. Still somewhere, something very incredible is waiting to be known.